everybody. Everyone's getting in the game, getting their warm-up rounds in.
Hello.
This is a replacement Ed.
No. I can't fill those shoes. I don't even need enough ramen.
Or massage enough anus.
Oh, you guys covered that, did you?
Yes, we covered makeup.
I must have missed that. I was listening to it for the majority. I think they said it was going to be 10 minutes, and then it's live after. It seems like quite a bit, but hey. So these are random teams. Okay, looks like it should be pretty good to watch. I don't think it would be too one-sided. I know a couple of the names here. Pepper plays CSGO at a competitive level, online, like ranked and that sort of thing. But I'm pretty sure that Renegade and Action, the guys from Nexus LAN, are pretty good at it as well. Pretty sure Mason's a pretty good FPS general. I know he plays CS2 and a couple of other ones, so. I don't know if you can actually get a good idea of how close the skill level is going to be during a warm up anyway.
I can't really see the difference.
It's a bold strategy, Cotton. We'll see if it pays off for him. Oh no, there he goes. All right.
Finally, let's spawn. No, he got an op. I mean, we won't hold the Cloud9 player against
him. I'm not familiar with Cloud9 in the CSGO arena. No, that's too bad. You can take
You're
over.
Soloing.
All right.
I have contractual obligations to attend to.
Evo is dealing with some power issues. If you did not know already, he is not only our resident streamer, but also our power guy. Best case scenario, the power guy is typically done the night before when we set up and is available to do such things as streaming. Unfortunately, that doesn't seem to be the case today for one reason or another. So he is taking care of that. And I will be running solo for a little bit while he gets them on. Not only is it a power outage, but it is apparently also a power outage for a couple of the participants in this tournament. I don't think it's anyone on our server that we're spectating currently. We appear to have... No, I lied. I think it actually is. So this is... This might get interesting. I don't see Pepper in here anymore, which, again, is kind of a personal friend. I know he plays Counter-Strike competitively, like ranked play. The upside is it looks like they're missing one from each team, so I don't think it'll be too difficult to remake this game from either perspective. Given the power outage, I am going to assume that we're in... Well, I'm not really sure what kind of state we're in, so for the sake of providing entertainment in the meantime, I'm going to kind of cycle through the people that are left and see what they're doing. Again, bear in mind they might not be taking this completely serious, given the fact that we might see this be remade, since we do have a couple of lost power. But again, we're going to treat it as though it's live, cycling through a couple of players here. You'll have to bear with me. I'm not the best as far as CSGO goes, map knowledge and whatnot, but we'll try to make sure that we see some people doing some things at least.
bomb has been planted.
You can see that they just planted a bomb at B point here.
Terrorists
playing B, and that went pretty fast. Again, it looks like we're missing people on both teams, so I'm not sure, you know, how serious they're going to take this match, but we'll continue to scroll through here. Terrorists took that first round, it looked like, by just eliminating the other team, although they did have the bomb down at B point as well, and were defending it pretty well, so I think that might have been inevitable. And here you can see in chat that they have confirmed that they're doing a reset if you have missing players, which is kind of what we expected. So until that time, bear in mind that's going to be what's happening, but we'll also do some spectates. Switch over just in time to see Mason taken out. Two members of the terrorist team. X-Red Dragon also taking out another member of the counter-terrorists. He's running through, sticking pretty close to B. He's probably going to plant the bomb here pretty soon. Got two members of counter-terrorism left up, and there they've been eliminated. Take that round again.
Just as a quick reminder, due to some power outages,
we will be remaking this game or resetting the server so that we get the full five players. You know, so at this point, it's mostly another warm-up. Still interesting to watch, nonetheless. We'll follow Mason around here for a little bit. It looks like he's moving towards point B. It doesn't look like he's going to find anyone there, however. It's probably going to be a little uneventful, but considering he's on the counter-terrorists, he's probably going to camp that point. I'll admit the past two rounds that we have been watching, it looks like they've been favoring B point for planting that bomb, so this is probably not a bad decision. We can actually see over the fountain one of the terrorists pop up and knife one of the counter-terrorists, and he actually takes out Mason too, who is protecting the B point, and sure enough, he's moved into the position to be able to plant that. It looks like he's just going to do kind of a round robin here. See if he can find any of the counter-terrorists still
in
this position.
None of the servers are live if you're missing people. We'll be restarting.
And there, you probably heard the announcement that we'll be restarting those servers. Again, in the meantime, we're just watching counter-terrorism move into position here. Unjustified is the only one still standing against three members of the terrorist team. And again, just as we were watching Mason before, sticking towards that B point, which we've seen them favor for planting that bomb.
Hey guys,
again,
I'm looking for Master Fry.
Terrorists, looks like they might not be taking this completely serious given the fact that we're going to restart, so
I'm not sure there's much worth casting at this point, but I'm going to do my best.
X-Red Dragon is standing on a fountain at the moment, and Ender is likely AFK. Unjustified, however, is going to be shooting deceased members of possibly... Oh, and there goes a couple of chickens. Okay. Oh, nice shot. That was a good, clean chicken kill. He's going to make sure that at plant B point, we're not going to have to worry about it. It looks like Unjustified wins by default due to the time limit.
Probably deserve that win just for being able to take out the poultry
such skillful fashion to begin with. So we'll start a new round here. 1-2 now.
Again, as a reminder for anyone that might be new joining us, we are going to be restarting the server due to a couple of participants dropping out through a power outage.
We are live at a LAN event. These sort of things do happen, so.
All right, guys. Unjustified, we're going to be restarting all the servers for the CSGO tournament once we have the power issues and the network issues
Mike
taken care of because of
the
power.
Spawn here. Let's keep an eye out, see if he takes any more chickens with him. He will find a member of the terrorists here. It looks like he's not going to kill him right away. He's going to choose instead to kind of play around with him, see if he can get his attention, stand on his head, defy gravity, all of those good things. Now he is looking down on him. Oh, that's what you get for not taking him out, I guess. Ender deals him justice for standing on his teammate's head. Now we have action as well, going to be taking out some chickens. Clearly, we do not tolerate chickens on our map. He did spot another one, I think, to his right. We'll see if he deals with him, but it looks like he's under fire. Action. Looks like Ender is still looking to distribute some justice. We could probably call him the sheriff. He has found another
terrorist here, our counter terrorist, I'm sorry, does take out Mason again. He's going to track him down. He's going to find those chicken-killing villains, and he's going to take care of them for us. Definitely want to stay tuned to this. We've still got Action Live looking around again. Action is the one that we just saw kill that chicken. He's the most recent culprit. It'll be interesting to see if Sheriff Ender is able to take care of him. Slowly walking up, he knows that he's got hostiles. He's not sure if he's got two AFKs that he's against there on the counter-terrorist side, but he is proceeding with caution. Action almost walks directly over the bridge that he's under. And it looks like counter-terrorists are going to take that just due to a timeout on the round. We'll start again fresh here. It looks like we might have some more active players now instead of a couple AFKs. Again, another reminder, we will be resetting the server. This is not live matches. Ender is on the move as usual. Nothing is going to stop him. X-Red Dragon has the bomb, it appears, but he is stationary. Unjustified in Action, both on the counter-terrorist, are live and running. At this point, they're either going to be killing chickens or trying to track down Ender. It'll be interesting to see which. Looks like we do have a fight. Nice headshot with the Akimbo pistols there from Ender. Wouldn't expect anything less from our resident sheriff. If you look at the map, it looks like he is hot on the trail of S. Mason, following him somewhat slowly. Again, he is outnumbered. He knows that his teammate is AFK. So he's proceeding with caution. Not killing those chickens again. That's the type of, you know, justice you expect from our teamed up there with the counter-terrorists, and they take that round again. X-Red Dragon, we actually have seen some activity from him, so we might see an even fight here, depending on how many counter-terrorists we have active. Pulling out the knife, run a little faster. Again, you can see that the terrorists, traditionally the villains, are not killing the chickens. Sticking together, very wise. They're going to encounter a member of the counterterrorism team here shortly, it looks like. Throws a grenade. He does catch him there in the corner. Nice headshot there, despite having a grenade live on the ground. But Action does take him out across the other side of the alley. And as he throws a grenade, tries to toss it after a short cook, and unfortunately is not able to do anything there, and counter-terrorists do take that round once again. We are rooting for the terrorists, though. They're the underdogs of the story. They do have their AFK back in this game. I might have spoken too soon. It looks like Red Dragon is AFK once more, but that is... Oh, we do have Haley now being active. So Sheriff Ender is not alone. We'll be seeking out the chicken-killing counter-terrorism team, and unfortunately gets shot down as I am speaking them up. X-Red Dragon is still alive back at the base, making sure that, you know, nothing takes place in his short field of vision here without moving. Haley, however, is on the move. S. Mason, AFK. Action is on the move as well. Haley finds one of the AFKs and takes care of Mason. Again, note the absence of any chicken shooting. Moving towards B point, pulling up the scope defensively to see if there's anything there. Notice the chicken in the scope. She's not going to take advantage of that chicken. A little suspicious that there might be someone camping. And again, well, this was more of a legitimate round. We did see both teams vying for the B point strategically, either camping it defensively to try to stop a plant or to rush that point as terrorists to plant the bomb. Again, we are going to be remaking the server, so this is mostly in fun at this point until that does take place. But we do have Haley trying to track down. It looks like Action, really, are the only two live. Red Dragon is in, but AFK, I assume. He moved a little bit there, and there he does draw his pistol. So we do have a 2v1 going on now. Haley has picked up the bomb and has moved into position on A. She's going to continue with the objective of planting that bomb. Hopefully it doesn't hurt that chicken. That would be a shame to hurt their reputation that they've gained over this. And again, even now when she's waiting, she's not going to take out those chickens. That's very nice. Very virtuous of her. Does pull out the knife, ready to play defensive, but Action honestly is way on the other side of the map.
at B point. Can't blame him, as you might have picked up again. You know, B has been the popular point. That's where he kind of moved out of habit, I think. But the bomb is unfortunately at A. Looks like he realizes that at this point, and he's moving into position, but he's probably not going to make it. Red Dragon doesn't move fast enough to avoid getting taken out by action, so it's just Haley left to defend point A. They are going to meet each other, and it'll be interesting to see. And the bomb goes off right at the end. Scoring that one for terrorists. Good bomb plant there, taking that back over. It's like we might have a knife round going on here. It was proposed in chat. We'll see if anyone actually obeys. Unjustified certainly has drawn his knife and is ready to duel. Action, however, is running with a silenced pistol. Not sure if that is a intentional troll trying to be sneaky. He's not going to take out the fish. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, another act of cruelty from the counterterrorism team, trying to take out the fish in the water. And in response, Ender takes out Unjustified. Sheriff Ender, again, dealing that justice. We'll switch over to his perspective to see how it's going. Terrorists are actually moving into objective formation, carrying that bomb and moving as a group, circling around A point, but I think they might decide to go towards B ultimately, but they are going to run into S Mason and take him out as X-Red Dragon takes his anger out on the inanimate light swinging.
Demonstrating some pretty neat
physics of the game. Puts us at 4-4 match point. We might be moving into position. No, we are going to continue with the next round. Again, just a quick reminder for anyone watching. This is essentially a practice, a fun round. Ender, Sheriff Ender, has left the game. It looks like they're probably going to be remaking shortly. X-Red Dragon, ouch, takes out a chicken. He's on the terrorist side, who were generally known for not partaking in animal cruelty, but he does take out a chicken on his way out. Might be switching sides. There's another one. Incredible. It's like he's the only one left on me. Oh, and there we go. Terrorist will take that round. Oh, I think I know what might have happened. It looks like we did have a side swap due to the point of the match. So I guess it makes sense that he was taking out chickens. That's the role that the counter-terrorists seem to want to fill. So we do have kind of a role reversal. We'll see if they adhere towards the traditional presentation of terrorists not attacking animals. Unjustified here sees gunfire, wisely hides behind any kind of shielding he can find. Patiently for X-Red Dragon to be in the corner. Unfortunately, he has his teammate close behind him. For whatever reason, I'm not sure if Haley was reloading or perhaps trying to draw a knife for a melee kill. He has time to switch out the bomb and then to a knife and take that opponent out, impressively, taking that round for them. Excuse me, we do have Pepper reloading back in. Again, Pepper was hoping that we could see drop due to the power outage here locally. So that is an encouraging sign that we might actually see the competitive side of this round be shortly. We're going to switch to his perspective. I hope that wasn't too loud. I apologize. We are going to switch to Pepper's perspective and watch him long enough just to see the round end there. We've seen a lot of the other players that have been in this tournament so far, this warm-up round, but let's go ahead and spectate Pepper for a little bit, just get a kind of an idea on where he stands, kind of guns he may be using, his affiliation as far as killing chickens go. And again, he bypasses that. He's not interested in those chickens. Wildlife in general, his game is the enemy team, and he takes out Red Dragon with that FAMAS. They're probably going to make fun of me for pronouncing that incorrectly, from across the alley without much trouble. Looks like Haley got a sniper kill. She's the only one left, and it looks like they are going to meet each other. She's still got that sniper out. She's going to have to be quick on it. The bomb was planted. She's going to have to make a decision, and unfortunately, she met Pepper there in the alley, who put that to an end quickly. We're at technical match point. Again, this is a warm-up round. So we will watch and see if the underdogs now on the counterterrorism team will be able to take out the three members on the terrorists. With X-Red Dragon going down early from a sniper kill from Pepper, it's not looking promising, but Haley might be able to pull it through. Let's switch over to her as she actually takes out Pepper. I try to switch to her perspective, and we miss it, unfortunately. But you can see now, she is no longer interested in killing chickens. She's going to move into position 1v2 at this point, trying to find action in Unjustified. Now, they're more around the A point. She's favoring B. We'll see if she can move and find them. In time, they don't seem to be tracking the bomb at all. And it looks like they're just out for blood at this point. It's just a death match as they move into B, where Haley was just at. She's cycling around to A, probably suspicious that if they're not at the B point, they're looking at A. Little does she know that they're not interested in the bomb planning at all. Looks like we're throwing some weapons around now. Unjustified in action being the last two members on the terrorism team. Again, Haley's playing with the objective in mind, checking A point, having just been at B, but not really seeing any activity over here. We might have action moving into position for the bomb. Going to try to end this in the traditional manner, moving to A. Unfortunately, Haley's probably going to cycle back over to B. She will find Unjustified and take him out, but she's probably going to move up towards B, having just been at A, and we can see that action is going to plant that bomb. Expect to see her immediately move towards A to try to take him out and defuse. Of course, action is going to be on the defensive here. Looks like he's going to take position in the corner behind the crates. We'll see if Haley is going to be able to take them out. Well, that was a little anticlimactic. I think the server just may have restarted there. Please switch to the right teams. Okay, so again, as we were explaining before, this is more of a fun makeup practice round as we got the other participants back in. I am rejoined by Debo, which I hope means that we've gotten the power issue sorted out. I will let him retake his rightful position here on the stream.
You're doing good. It's just that chair is uncomfortable.
It is somewhat uncomfortable. I agree with that. I'm okay. We'll see how this one goes for a little bit.
Should be fixed.
Good. So, as we found out, they were definitely two people in our game that had dropped due to power issues. It's good to hear that they've been sorted out, though. So, do you know, are we going to go back to a 10-minute warm-up round, or are we going to jump right into a live?
We're going to try to go live, because we got to get this tournament in before.
I can imagine. We're a little bit behind schedule at this point. So you can see we're trying to form the teams again. The interesting dynamic in the warm-up round that you might have seen is that Haley and Pepper were on opposing teams. I think in the live tournament they will be on the same team. So maybe they got a little chance to take out some anger with one another in the little fun round. If you remember to about 15 minutes ago or so when we were first casting the warm-up before the power outage, it looks like these teams are assembling correctly. Hopefully we get them in without any issue.
Sorry, I'm not leaving you back on the island. I'm just checking to make sure no screens go black.
You can't blame them. We've had a few power issues, mostly due to incorrect methods of connecting your computer, which we try to communicate clearly, but it is a little perhaps confusing. Thank you. That's my phone. So hopefully we've gotten those all straightened out, at least for the duration of the tournament, so we can get this started, as Steve-O
hinted towards. I'll take duration of the match at this point.
Yeah, I agree. Are any other servers live, or are they all waiting on this one pretty much?
I think this one took 3 people out of a total of 2, but it looks like we're about to go live here.
Great. Excellent. So hopefully we will get confirmation. They usually announce here at the LAN so everyone knows. Oh, that's a bummer.
Because, hey.
I cast the last 15 minutes of AFKs and people standing on fountains, and we get kicked for inactivity in the end. That is irony.
We're going to go to the Dust 2 server because they look like they got 10 people and they're going.
Okay. Well, so all that buildup for the players in that server, you can just forget that now. We're moving to new ones.
We're doing it live.
We're doing it live, ladies and gentlemen. We will fill you in, hopefully, and form our own opinions and fictional stories of the players in this server, just like we did before. Are these live? I would assume these are live.
This is just fresh live. One game to the CCs, node to the terrorists. Looked like they had really good pistol rounds.
Not really, stacking of kills. Looks like it's well distributed through the team. Hopefully, kind of foreshadowing a good distribution of skill that we'll be able to kind of spectate here.
Yeah, looking like a B rush.
Yeah, counter-terrorist team is sticking together in a formation. It looks like.
Rose stuck in the pit alone. Oh, Red Riser from the door. Headshot through.
Kind of a little bit of a choke point. I think he's expecting some people to come through, and I don't know that he's going to find what he's looking for there. Again, we've really just got the counter-terrorists here.
And we switch speeds back in the long hallway. We got a kill.
Terrorists are pretty much split between the two locations.
And they're completely wiped out with the double back into A.
Counter-terrorists, yep, do take that round again.
So an economy round for the terrorists and a full buy round coming in for Tylord. Four kits. A little excessive. But the op already off a Red Riser.
Someone to come through there, he's not gonna find it. Do get looks a quick like kill on Tylord there. From the counter or I'm sorry, from the terrorists. That's hopefully a good sign in their favor. That is nasty.
Trapped didn't even have to leave, and he got two kills.
Yeah, that took out a lot of vision there for him, and it unfortunately just kind of took care of him through it.
They took themselves out with that smoke grenade.
So,
Fry and Logan
sticking together, but you know the counterterrorism team is pretty well distributed between all the points. They can pretty much react to just about any point. And unfortunately, he gets taken out. We do have a solo now. Counter-terrorism team. I'm sorry, on the terrorist team.
Yeah, three people, three different sprays.
I'll get these colors right eventually.
Tyler got taken out with the op the last game, so now he's just gone right back to the M4. And
a little bit of a spray there.
Clip
that was interesting.
For nothing.
Shorter. Shooting blind into Shorter. The smoke, hopefully to take someone out. It doesn't
it's a
do anything
10.
There.
What are you gonna do?
It's like again, we see the terrorists sticking together in a group for the most part. It looks like we have one straggler way out there, but he might just be holding the position. Counter-terrorists are pretty well distributed between B and A, mostly favoring B. We do have the bomb, it looks like, moving to position on A, but they're going to find them. They're going to meet each other here, it looks like. We did have a flash there.
Out.
And there they find him.
Logan finds Goro short. Up here on the catwalk.
Better for terrorists on this
Red
round.
Red Riser is the one man left now.
Let's see if he can take out.
One on four, four terrorists sitting on the A. The bomb not yet down.
This is a good position for a team that's sticking together. You definitely have a numbers advantage and you're sticking tight, protecting that A point. It's going to take some pretty impressive moves from Red Riser to be able to take them out, and you know he's approaching it in the right manner, slowly. It's kind of on a clock at this point, but running in there and dying is not going to help anyone. So.
No, there's a point where you just save the op. Round's over, you're up 3-0. Just save the op. If you can get a kill, get a kill. If not,
at this point, you just have to imagine he's doing this for the stream. He's doing this for you viewers. He's trying to get in the last headshot.
There you go.
It's not a headshot, but still impressive.
Don't gotta hit much. Terrorists will take the round. Terrorists will preserve the op.
Like Debo said, it's only 3-1 though. They're still in a pretty good position, but hopefully we see more plays like that from the terrorists. Keep them in a game a little bit evenly matched here.
like we got a good old-fashioned B-Rush.
And well, we see the counter-terrorists also moving to position in the same manner. Are they switching over to A? Perhaps not. Maybe just coming up a different method?
Coming through middle just to control themselves. Red Riser still does have his op, so that op is going to have eyes on the door.
Yeah, that's a dangerous door to stick around there.
Looks like they're going through the middle to short A. Riser will probably rotate through the spawn, but...
They'll plant the bomb, but they don't have the manpower to defend it at A, I don't think. I think counter-terrorists are going to be able to respond to that a lot faster than the terrorist team will be able to. See some more smokes go out, it looks like.
Drag it out. Decent bomb damage.
Has been planted at A.
And Red Riser gets a kill. Boost up to the balcony. And
nice
3-1.
Trying to get
still
another
down
one.
Though. Judlin and... Oh,
he's
Red Riser
have
with another
to play
kill.
Defensive.
Judlin, Red Riser, and there Red Riser gets down. Another one. And bomb defused. Oh, Lincoln.
That's good. Good turnaround by the counter-terrorists on that win. One.
Juggling for three grenades that round.
I don't know if you were able to hear it on the stream, but here locally we heard some applause and cheers on that last
round.
Three on one. Always get a few cheers.
No.
Even from yourself. Got to pat yourself on the back for that one.
See a grenade get chucked there.
They're going long A.
One still up in mid.
All the defense on short A and B.
So I'm really impressed by the counter-terrorists, how they spread out between the two. Just expecting straight objective rushes, and that seems to be what's happening with the terrorists.
Don't let that bomb cross,
yeah,
please.
The issue is they don't get much information by spreading. And by the time they do get the information, they've already lost.
I'm going to cut them off.
Well, they seem to be doing fine just playing reactionary and taking out the members of the opposite team that are off the planet.
Congrats or not. Taken out by Fry. Albro's got the short A defense coming in.
I'm Kamikaze
even before
stop that team.
Set the bomb. There's a flash out.
Bomb has been planted.
Bomb down. No Molotovs. So he's going to have to hope he can take it off. Red Riser taken out by Fry.
The signature sniper too.
Oh, close there.
This would be interesting. Nice shot. It's a good round for the terrorists.
They needed a solid win, and they kept the off, which is the most important. So he's gonna switch. That's just a pickup. And it looks like full on rush. Long A.
Well, we thought last
they split
as
two
well.
In the middle.
Yep, there they go again.
They're just okay, it's a flat out rush to A and Grab's not gonna take it out by user, but
lack of communication.
There's a return kill.
Different
we got
ideas
three
showing.
On A for the CD
just hold
though.
Cap, please.
Bombs in. And it's 3-on-4.
B is pretty clear if they're paying any attention to that. It looks like either
they
by luck or
direction.
By knowledge, they are heading to B point now.
Someone didn't stay home, so now the terrorists are sitting in the B's behind with all the defense up.
Definitely going to take advantage of that.
Here they come too late.
Nice
Bone
grenade
taken
gets
out
defensively.
Running.
CT's definitely moving in on B, but cautiously. They've already lost
and Spud
two
sitting
members.
Here with Kamal in his sights. He's got a P90, unfortunately.
That is why you approach slowly. Kamikaze was waiting to take advantage of that.
We got Albro coming right out here, and we'll take it down. And Terrace win. Last round of the first half.
Bye.
This is to go in CTs 5-3 for the team for the side switch, or see if we can be even up before we switch sides.
I'm predicting a 4-4.
It seems like the Terrorists have gotten speed as they've been working together along the way. These are random teams.
They're going to knock over here in the hallway, and Kamikaze is not ready for that.
Got to be more, got to have more conviction with the P90 Rush. They are trapped behind the doors. Logan making a hole, though.
Still not having a problem taking out the CT team.
Now it's suddenly 4-on-1.
Kamikaze went down, and the rest of the team decided that they're going to play Vengeance.
Spawn. While the whole T team is just looking for blood.
He's still pulling out some kills, though.
Fry looking to get the plant in, and now it's 1-on-3.
It's going to put Obro on the move, for sure.
Obro at 5-2-5 is going against, well, the bottom half of Terror Squad. But most of the scores are a little off because of the...
I am certainly not an expert, but it does seem like Obro would want to start moving the position on B point, or it's going to be all over.
I think it's already over. I don't think he has enough time to actually get in there safely. I don't know why he'd save the Famas, unless he's like really low on money.
You're just biting the bullet to do
1900. He's just going to gun save because I don't think he'd do very much.
Even distribution as we go into the second half here, it looks like.
Yeah, the Terrorists just going to sit on their hallway. We crash.
This is how we do it.
All right. I think it's pretty safe to assume that they were going to move into 4-4 on that.
That was pretty easy.
Halftime there. Yeah. Although it might have been mind games, you know, as far as the CT team is concerned. Terrorists probably did not know what to think in that situation. And we're getting back in here.
Well, if you're going to disconnect at the break.
True. We needed a little bit of a recess there, but we're back.
Eric Johnson, can you jump into server 4? Eric Johnson, get into server 4, please.
Oh, Cerebro now. Didn't move into position to take the detonation, or take the bomb, but he is the one planting it when they're on the terrorism side. Kamikaze sees to that.
Well, how was the last time, though? They started out really well in the pistol round, but it looks like no kids.
Right in the back.
And Red Riser takes the match. Another pistol round.
Yo, I'm having to work way too hard for this. Come on.
What happens around after you rush A? Rush B.
Makes sense.
I mean, that's just what you do, right?
Let me work a little here.
So that's the problem with this time.
Somebody watch my long. Don't let him push long.
Almost gets an early kill there.
Takes a blank pot shot. Into the smoke. We got 2 and B. The action looking like it's moving to either long A or short. Yep, they're moving into the long A. And this is where the fun's gonna happen right here. They're all down long A. Red Riser's gonna have that. Here comes the smoke.
Not sure CT's prepared for
this. Tyler was sick. That's an interesting game.
And we see Red Riser taking out early kills with the Spider. Decent pickoff there from Tyler through the smoke. Although we do see CT showing some life here.
Really painting, nice fire down.
T90
spray wins the map for the CTs.
Alright, well, they're mounting a comeback. Maybe I spoke too soon. Maybe they can pull this back through.
Spud stole the op at the very last second. And I was apparently inactive despite switching friends. Okay. Okay. I mean,
can we find which server Witty is playing on? It looks like we have a request in the chat.
I can try to find Witty.
Yeah, we'll see if we can find that for you. Not this server, unfortunately. I think we'll try another one for you.
Yeah. We'll take a guess.
So, do you want to see Witty succeed or fail? What are you interested in seeing?
I think he's interested in making fun of Witty, because Witty's actually hosting us.
Oh, is that right?
And there's nobody in this server.
This is quite a server.
I am trying to find you, Witty.
Fail Kappa. All right.
We got dank themes going on here, man. This is more of a... No Witty here, but we get to make fun of Garfield.
I assume he's using that as a Steam name. I could be a poor assumption.
Yeah, Witty's not on my friends list, so...
Counter-terrorists win.
His Steam name is Witty. Okay.
Here we get to make fun of boss on the pistol round.
Oh, lovely. So he'll catch this on the replays, probably.
Oh,
this,
definitely.
This
gotta
is
make
this
fun
is Wes, which would be the head organizer for LAN OC, which is, you know, this event. Somewhat impressive. Oh, we have all kinds of staff members in this round.
There were two people that didn't sign up for the match, so.
I see. At least they're against one another.
Despite sitting back to back. LAN OC is held every 6 months, twice a year. We hold an event in March and an event in
September. LAN OC is held every year. I'm sure you probably filled him into that. So Witty is actually on a team that got a bye in the first round. So probably not
Witty
too exciting for
play.
You.
He won without doing
that. Yeah. Yeah, so he'll be in.
Call that handicap.
To be honest, he's on a pretty good team, too. I believe it's got Polar and some of the other Shadow Wolves on there, so. It'll definitely
the
be
Shadow Wolves managed to stack themselves again?
I think so. I'm not sure. What server are we spectating at the moment? It's 4 and 4.
I thought you were on server 1.
With the Dust 2?
We switched a couple.
We've switched.
We're just trying to figure out because we're waiting on them to finish so we can get team one playing.
There's still 10 playing, but they were pretty even. They went in 4-4 in the middle break.
Oh, that was the original what we were watching.
We have a request back from the guy who was throwing the last match, or somebody was playing on Rob's computer. I don't know which.
Was someone playing on your computer? We saw your account. Okay. So Rob wasn't actually playing.
Explains why he actually got kills. We are 6-8.
Damn.
So two Daves killed someone, so. He got banned, so we had to give him a mic
computer
so he could.
Two Daves, like, team
back
killed?
Banning team
very
kills.
Nice.
Nice.
That's always fun to pull off at a LAN. We're back to the original server, for those who were in suspense. 6-8, so showing a little fight in them. That's good.
Bomb is going up the middle, I think. Yep. Nope. He's making it to the tunnel.
a little separated from the rest of his team. He's taking points here.
Heading back into the spawn. He's heading back into T spawn, or he's just stuck in fog. Looking for a safe place. Very close. T's playing close to the vest.
Yeah.
This is actually a match point, so they win one more, they're done.
Probably wisely moving back to Monster.
And there's one.
Oh
down,
my god, Morgan. Right? That didn't afford him any safety being with his team, unfortunately.
Frag out. Tyler getting the kill. Tyler's got to come out for the bomb, though. Bomb is down on the ground in B with an op standing on top of it. And map over. CT's win. We're not done yet. We might go to tiebreaker.
We'll be here all night, folks.
How was it?
Yeah?
Yeah. I got me and some other guys.
I thought you did.
So. Oh, did you? Yeah, Red Dragon. Yeah, higher rank. But I had better score than him at the end of the game, though, so.
Obviously.
Top of the game. 16
yeah.
And
5. Red Dragon back with his up. Not without his stickers, though, which means he stole that one. Long A seems to be the call with one person down in the tunnels. But Sir Fry seems to be camping the car.
He's gonna find the full soon.
And Ebro's down.
Take out the first.
Bomb's down on the ground.
See what else he has. Probably gonna keep an eye on that bomb. Peeks out a little too far there, unfortunately. Tyler has a way of doing that.
Red Riser trying to clear the hall. Boys team.
That's a good attempt.
But now CTs have gone into a pretty defensive position around A. The bomb is down right in front of them, so. Spud doing a good job holding off three people, including an op.
Yeah, not
they're
bad.
They're gonna try to come through. No, not Shorty. They're coming up to the spawn. Nope. Yep. There's throwing through short. And Logan's down. Red Riser with his op coming up and taken out by Spud. Spud setting up the match. No longer
wow.
Tied. We're going.
Here it is.
Tie. Break.
Wasn't it impressive? I mean, they really anticipated where they're gonna approach from and. Got a few early picks there for on the terrorist side that dropped that bomb and just allowed them to kind of control the area, I think. And we're kicked once again.
Still better than power going out.
That's true. That's true.
But we're going to have to reset into train there. Or is it overtime?
I think we're still tied up, aren't we? Oh, well, let's see if we can't get anyone else back, Ben. So, as someone who doesn't play this game often, what just happened here? Are we...
We tied. As per the rules, we're going to be trained.
It's Inferno.
This
is a different server?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
One more actual stuff is happening.
You're not going to stream the overtime then?
Yeah, we're going back.
Okay.
I just, you know, figured actual things happening is better.
You base that on what? I'll hit it if I want. Act like you've got sensitive audio equipment or something on this table. Those are some nice masks that they have there.
Underwear with holes, I do believe. They're French terrorists.
It's very nice.
Cheech with a knife. Cheech is actually pretty good at this game.
Cheech is pretty talented at just about any game I've seen him play.
I actually grew up having or being at LAN parties when I was like 16.
Yeah?
He's been doing this a while. He's a vet.
Underwear with holes. That's all you really need.
Looks like map change is happening in the server one real quick. Just hit half time here.
Unfortunately,
Garfield
is not using his computer. I believe someone else is using his computer as well. So
sadly, we cannot berate him for the
He is watching very intently, though.
I can still berate Garfield for his terrible skill set.
We're not that far from him, and we can continue to say Garfield until he notices we're talking about him.
But he looks pretty engrossed.
He does. Karrison's noticed us. Or Pepper, you'll probably see him later on in the tournament. But Garfield, however, still oblivious. That's impressive. Okay, back to the game anyway.
I'm trying to figure out what... Okay, teaser an apartment. Heading towards A. Cheech is just now realizing they missed the boat here.
Cheech has the bomb again. It's very familiar to the last round.
They snuck through the apartment right after him. Remember, kids. Hold down the wall.
Cheech is being sneaky here, but they've got the number. Off a couple as they try to detonate.
They don't even see him.
Oh, they're doing gross.
Oh, now they do. Fire now he's gone. Pinhead with the defuse. No kit, though.
I can't imagine that that underwear provides much, like, peripheral vision, unfortunately.
Bomb has been and defuse if they...
Counter-terrorists win.
MVP. 60% of the enemy team for Pinhead Larry.
We're gonna go check in on said other server.
That's how we do it here on the Lano C stream. We get you engrossed in one server and then we jump to the other one.
Gotta keep moving.
That's right. Back to train though, this is the overtime, right?
This is the overtime with the teams that are actually even the match.
Okay.
I feel like I just flamed somebody.
I think you did.
Thank you, stream guys, for jumping into one
play. I just did.
See how it's going. Jared jinxed us. I hope they don't try.
They still only playing.
Oh, we're pulling out all the ties here.
He keeps giving me an inactivity.
Just kicking you?
Yeah. I guess.
Oh, wait a minute. So we have to do a warm-up even in the overtime, huh?
I think he's going to kill the kill
that. Okay, okay. All right, cool.
Because without that, 10 minutes is just waiting on these guys so Team 1 can finally play.
Which would be Witty.
Which would be Witty.
Witty gets the winner of this?
Yeah, Witty gets this, Witty gets the winner of this.
All right, well, there you have it. Witty will be with us shortly.
I mean, this guy thinks we're hilarious, Adam. We should scream all together.
Yeah, we should.
I mean, we'll have to go.
So you took that to a place that's going to lead to nothing but disappointment.
There's only three people. They can't be
two. By everyone.
One of them is you.
All of us.
One of them is me.
We'll make teams compete. So...
We're not that big.
Well, it's an interesting thought, and... the debate between random teams and bring your own team is almost as fierce as Pepsi versus Coke.
Coke always wins.
We have people that feel very strongly both ways. We actually used to do two tournaments for every title selected, one that was BYOT and one that was random. So you may have guessed from just some random chatter how much time this is already taking. That took a lot more time to actually operate.
What's this fat? He's going to eat. Oh, buddy.
Yeah. Hi, Wes.
I think that's good. I managed to pick the one map that's actually pretty competitive. Bomb is at B, being defended. Down to two terrorists, one terrorist, bomb on the ground. I got into the train station and just got picked apart. Red Riser, again. Give the man a pistol, a pistol round, give the man an op.
You know, CSGO actually is one of the more competitive titles that we get at the LAN. And what I mean by that is that we've got a pretty good group of people, a fairly large number, who are fairly decent at the game. Some of the other titles we tend to get, you know, maybe five or so people that are just way above the other ones. But CSGO tends to bring in a couple people that are just very well skilled at the game. And you can kind of see that here. I mean, most of what we spectated is close to tied rounds. They are random teams that were selected for this LAN. It's not necessarily going to be what we do at every LAN, but that was what was favored for this one. So we do see that skill somewhat distributed, give or take, based on RNG. But so far, they've been pretty good matches to watch.
CT looked to be firmly in control of this map, though. Taking the pistol round and then the subsequent buy-in round. Dumped out to a big lead, dropped the bomb in a hallway, and now the T's are split up, can't decide if they want to, which way they want to go around. Pylord dropped by Fry, the bomb was kind of just hanging out. Looks to be making his way back around, but Red Riser's right there, so that's a...
inactivity.
Gonna have to get that fixed.
I'm not entirely convinced that it's not detecting how little you're moving in your chair and kicking you for that.
Saying I'm lazy?
No. I'm saying we need another power outage to get you up on the floor.
Please don't say that. 3-0 to the CTs.
Don't.
It does seem to happen at a convenient time. At least we're in between rounds here. So we're coming in this one fresh.
I'm switching players. I don't know what more action they want out of me. They want me to...
You need to get excited.
Wheel?
Do you have your pen? The caster pen?
Caster pen's right here.
Okay.
People can't see me, so it doesn't matter.
You need to wave it around a little bit as we talk. It makes us look official. That was probably a little ambitious
some
there.
Some bad spray to the ground. Red Riser gets flashed. Debro takes out Judlin. Bomb is hovering towards B, heading back towards A.
And not Logan. Teammate as they approach.
Back in the big yard.
Well, looks like wisely it pays off for him. They're able to take out Red Riser, who has traditionally been, at least as far as we've seen, favoring long range weapons. So probably a good threat to take out early.
Still got a weird bounce, but ends up in the right place. Bomb is down. And now the CTs get to circle around. Looks like Tyler's going to be the first one on the scene.
Fairly even match, but CT is split. Take out one. Tipping out.
Jumps right over the second guy. Turns around, takes him out anyway. Bomb's still on the ground, but...
That's true. See, Tyler can either defuse or take out the last member and then try to turn his eyes to the objective.
I don't think he cares too much about playing with pliers.
Not Logan is just trying to stay alive at this point. Does take out Clone. Who is our CT member way up there? Tyler. Going out wide.
Terrorist win, but he got
a gamble there. Yeah.
in the wind.
I think he was hoping to catch someone up there, and unfortunately just didn't pay off for him. We have some applause here, so...
Something good happened, but I think it was in the other server. Looks like the terrorists have decided to just pay guard one last time, they might as well do it again.
I was definitely doing it.
But unfortunately, that means...
Yeah, that is why you want to take out Red Riser early, because he will, well, take you out.
Bullet to the head, it's the end of Red Riser, though.
Yeah, he does down.
Bebo takes out user, Logan responds with Psy Lord. Bebo takes out Fry.
Back down to only one member, but you know that didn't stop him last time.
Logan camp on the ladder up in the office.
Not Logan this time. Definitely not Logan.
Watching that bomb.
He's in a good position here, actually.
Bebro is the kit, so.
I don't know that he knows where that gunfire is coming from. He decides just to drop off of the car. Do they know where not Logan is? They do find him.
They got him.
I don't know.
That's 4-1 CPs.
Start taking reservations. The registration for the events. I'm not sure if there is a, you know, concrete time when they open.
We're staff, and I think we get told what happens.
Yeah. Unfortunately. The dates aren't always consistent, so it's not like we can say, you know, definitely this far between, but LandoC.org. Yeah, yeah. If
it'll
we
be
could
post on the forums about a week before it happens.
If we could go into sellout mode here and advertise the Facebook, Twitter, our forums, all of those are mediums that we post up pretty well in advance when we're going to be opening up registration. The dates for the next events are decided and locked in at this point. I believe they're in March, the end of March. So yeah, we definitely encourage you to check that out. Follow us. Keep an eye out for those registration and see you hopefully.
And that is for the debon, the fuse. 5-1.
Bomb has been defused. Counter terrorists win.
What'd he say?
That's telling. He's already on back then for the team kill. So there's only like a 10-minute.
Okay.
Which is funny because I think that's a first defense where Winkus did it last time.
I don't think we typically announce through Steam, but we can suggest that and see if we can get something announced there as well.
We tried to get West to do something with Steam group. I don't think we've got a post in Steam group.
We've tried to drive it, especially with as much popularity as like CSGO and Dota have been bringing into Steam lately.
Got 5 votes, man.
We're not gonna pursue that, but yeah, definitely join the group there and we'll see if we can't make that happen for sure.
Terrorists have had a plant on all but one round in this map, and the CTs are up 5-1. So they need to get their defense down. Looks like they do, though. It's all up to Psy Lord. And he's going the wrong way.
Yeah, I think we've seen Psy Lord take a
Doesn't
couple of gambles
kit,
here.
So
he's just going
to
catch his breath at this point. Again, you know.
Can't put a corner. I thought we weren't playing Call of Duty.
Damn. It'll put him in a 5-2, still a good position to be in, so.
On top.
Yeah. And your next game?
I don't know.
A terrorist win.
We we have Pepper here with us. Pepper, you want to come in and say a few words?
Am I in the thing?
I think. It's a pretty powerful mic. There's no cam. It's just
audio. Oh, okay.
Yeah. So,
is this the tiebreaker?
So, this is the tiebreaker. It's 5-2, but the terrorists have planted 6 of the 7 knives. CC's got 5.
Interesting. It's a bold move, Cotton.
I wish we had not already used that joke.
No.
But we have.
Me and you, we don't have much.
Obviously someone's behind
them. They stopped in the hall this time. Normally they just go out and plant.
They're coming right behind them. Guaranteed.
Boom, boom, boom in the room.
Take too long.
6-2 in the halftime.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, from one of the winning teams. Someone that actually plays this game and knows things about it. What's up?
You don't need to know things about
the
game to talk about it.
Is food in the refrigerator, and if so, which one?
Generally, we use the, like, if you go through the kitchen, past the first room to the left, there's like a... Take a break, even, you know, when there's CSGO matches going. Always on duty. Who, Wes?
Evildoer.
Oh, Evildoer.
How's it going on the tiebreaker?
2-6.
The voice you hear now is Plague, one of the individuals running the tournament.
You can't see finger
points.
Hi.
Has anyone seen Evildoer?
We got Logan and Judlin camping a bomb site like they did as they were terrorists. Debro trying to circle around.
I'm gonna poke my head outside.
Yeah. Go check.
Hold on, I'm gonna keep.
Oh, okay.
What team were you?
What team?
Team 6-2.
Okay. Five is not. Chinese, but now I'm hungry.
I got some,
That is not Chinese food.
I mean, whatever. You said you were hungry, you didn't say for what. Debro and Jedlin. Jedlin hanging out in A. Debro moving into B, gonna get the plant. He's got 10 seconds to get the plant. This is gonna be a long map. He's gonna plant it with 4 to go. And now there's 45 seconds more to go.
All right then.
Jedlin knows where it is. Pistol on pistol.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't figured it out yet, get comfortable because this stream, this tournament is going to go on for quite a while, and we will be here with you to provide adequate commentary at the best throughout the entire event. So
adequacy is what we strive for.
That's right.
And of course, you know, they were just about to shoot each other out.
I keep telling Debo
like
to get
Jedlin
up
won.
And do some jumping jacks.
I assume Jedlin won.
I think Jedlin won.
I mean,
MVP Jedlin. All right.
He used the bomb.
So, of course, brings us closer to that tie once again. Wouldn't expect anything less of our already overtime mode here.
Plague, I don't like your setup because it kicks due to inactivity and I'm a spectator.
What?
It kicks due to inactivity and I'm a spectator.
I don't know that I can look at my config. I didn't set the kick for inactivity. What, so if you're not moving the mouse, it kicks you?
Yeah.
I'm moving the mouse, switching people, talking, shooting your shit.
I'll see if I can spot it. I'll kill it.
Hi.
We're missing out on some action here. Looks
bomb
like
down in
CT game. Might take another one, although we're tied up here. Bomb planted. As long
long range little duel here.
P90 shootout.
Kamikaze coming through once again. The kill. I'm gonna have to act fast on that bomb.
P90 ran out of juice.
Keep going, keep going. Oh no, he reset the time.
Couldn't make it, neither of them.
Okay. Alright then. Ty Lord, yeah. You know, you can't play at 100% every round, unfortunately.
Yeah, you can. Aren't these guys pros? Are they just some weekend warriors that we found out of nowhere?
I don't think that's the case. Definitely pro level here.
I mean, this is like the youth team for Cloud9. Envious or somebody, right?
I know nothing about what you just said, and just the fact that you said it means it was probably an insult.
Fnatic youth team? Is that what these guys are? You're doing pretty well on another pistol round.
I was looking to make up for the last round there. And I say that, Judlin puts him down.
Means it's up to D-Bro, the only guy with a gun.
I believe that's O-Bro.
Oh, it's D-Bro.
Is it D?
Yep.
All right, then.
I can read letters, you can't. It's okay.
It's, you know, it's the...
Judlin watching the bomb.
The monitor that's furthest from me, in my defense. You can't hear it, but here at the LAN, there are people catcalling for this 1v1 at this moment. Let's go for a grenade.
That
flash.
That is a flash. Judlin... Hit by it,
I have no doubt in Judlin. He's going to pull this one through for us. Bring the 4-7.
Which means Zero's going to plant the bomb and kill him, right?
Judlin, no! So I am... I jinx people, don't I?
Yep.
Okay. Match
so
point.
So who are you cheering for?
Match point. Here we go.
Because that's who's going to lose.
I am cheering for this first round to be accomplished in a timely manner. Watching them die. We're enjoying it quite a bit too.
Everybody dies. That's the point of CSGO.
You know, D-Bro has really stepped up in these past couple of matches.
I mean, Tylor shit the bed last few rounds.
Now that I say that, D-Bro is immediately going to get shot in the head. I'm waiting for it.
Here, we'll go to him.
All right, let's see how I curse this fella.
Or he'll drop that HE grenade to his feet.
That's not happening.
Bomb is down on the ground between A and B up in the office, I think that is. Yep, being watched over by Fry.
Sir
UNP.
Fry, to you.
I'll call him Sir if he defends his bomb correctly. He's got a person coming in the lockers, person coming through the hallway.
I really hope this happens.
Covers the bomb and his life. No. Can the terrorists win? The match is over. Let's watch Witty.
Are we ready for Witty?
Are we ready for Witty? I think we're ready for Witty.
We still had an AFK at the very beginning.
Rip AFK.
GG indeed. Witty or Riot?
I don't even know who Witty is.
I think he's the guy you gotta play right now.
Yeah, so good luck.
I gotta play.
No, you're not playing yet?
I'm team 5.
I don't know what that means. Team 1 got a bye, I think. Which
yeah,
is
team 1 is Witty.
Well, yeah, so whoever won this one's playing team 1, and then we're playing the winner of the bad
team. Oh, okay.
This is the world's weirdest structure ever.
So Kerrison's, yeah. Also known as Pepper in game. Is rooting for Witty as well, and could be,
don't
you know,
is Witty good?
His opponent. Is Witty good, chat?
You guys should put up a straw poll.
Yeah, we'll make a straw poll real quick.
All five people, including me and Adam. Is Witty good?
Witty is pretty good.
Witty is pretty good?
Witty's pretty good.
Witty's pretty.
We're going to try to find his game and spectate him if you want to watch some of his...
Of course,
get some intel on this player.
In
intel on this witty guy.
Wait a minute, Train, are we going to do another overtime game, or is this just normal map?
It's not the normal map.
He's Master Guardian Elite. Is that a thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that pretty high?
I think that's fire.
Oh, that's what Pepper is, too, so.
We have a legendary eagle on our team.
Apparently, there is such a thing as a legendary eagle, and they have one on their team.
Every land,
that would be Pepper.
I carried my fucking team last CSGO tournament. Like, I was like 40-0. Legit.
I hope, can they hear him? I hope they can. Yeah.
They should be able to. They can hear the crowd.
Okay, good.
Why?
Thunder.
Because it's a break from Debo and I.
Oh.
Steady other voice. You want to pull up a chair?
I mean, Curious is not quite Lumbert level in LoL where he gets carried to a tournament.
Oh, God.
Well, Lumbert carried me. Remember, he coached me.
Get a chair. Come on. We're going to be joined by Pepper here while he waits for his game. Legendary Eagle is higher than Master Guardian Elite.
Team 1.
And what's
the nuke map?
Server 1.
Server 1.
And they'll be starting in about 10 minutes.
Okay, are they on warm-up right now?
No, we're letting the team who just won take a 10-minute break.
What about Server 2?
Server 2 is Team 6 and 2.
It's like worlds.
You know, it's funny like when you sit next to Adam.
I don't think we have pens for everyone.
And you hit
though.
The mute button, and he just like hyping stuff up.
I can hear the games, but I can't hear you guys.
Yeah, I had the mic muted.
Oh, you had the mic muted? We've been talking gold, and they couldn't even hear us.
Oh God! My. Is Wink is shooting people again? Oh, that's Bob Xander.
Okay. Well, we have three of us now. We're joined by Pepper. You'll be seeing play later. Probably
threw me on a team. I got killed.
Shooting people in heads.
Mark my words. That's at least 10 kills.
At least, okay, so next game, 10 kills from Pepper. Like one round or just like?
10 kills on Witty.
The whole match.
The whole match.
Yes, single handedly on Witty. Every single round I'm going to kill.
Ladies
Witty.
And gentlemen,
me versus Witty.
10 kills on Witty from Pepper every round. Is that what I heard?
Not every round. One kill
That's
around.
Impressive,
One
sir.
Kill around.
One kill around. Okay.
But, I mean, we'll only need 9 rounds. It'll go 9-0.
Oh.
I might not be able to follow through.
You're about to get 9-0.
I know. I'm going
to fucking cry. What, Team 2 is going to get into your server on
These are, we have some people
server
in chat.
Server 2,
that
thank you.
Witty Stream.
Oh,
so.
Okay.
We kind of baited you into the chat.
Oh, that's
there.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's okay. I have a stream also,
so
when I shit on him, you can come to my stream instead.
I don't think you have a stream.
I will make a stream.
Oh, okay. All right, so
I don't have Twitch replays.
You mentioned. Oh, no.
I don't even know who Witty
you
is.
Should. Please do that.
Just message Witty, tell him Pepper called about it.
Yeah.
Like,
a kill around is what he said. And 9-0, I think that
but
was
But he might not get
there.
To 10 because they're just going to 9-0.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to handing Witty the tournament prize later on tomorrow. So we're in warm-up right now for another server, just kind of waiting. It doesn't even look like they've got all their players in there yet, unfortunately.
No, but I'll probably be kicked for inactivity here soon.
That's true. You probably will be kicked for inactivity. They may have fixed it. Maybe when you said something to Plague, he fixed it. So
I doubt it.
I can hope.
I don't have high hopes for anything.
All right, then.
We should be wearing our hats.
Why? There's no camera.
Alrighty, guys.
I'm over here using the pen, and no one can see it.
Evildoers team, that's Gareth Johnson, Mick Cowbell, Pinhead Larry, and two mates. Okay, server 2, please, on the terrorist side.
As you can probably hear, we are calling
guys,
the rest of the members
the Rocket
for the
League
server.
Tournament will be locked out at 9 o'clock, and we will be starting it at 9:30.
Wait, are these going to overlap then?
pretty sure they are, aren't they?
What? Yeah.
What? No, I mean, like, are the CSGO and the Rocket League tournaments going to overlap?
I'm hoping not.
What time is it? Okay.
I'm hoping not, but the way things are looking with people not getting into the server, we'll probably have to
play. Hey, buddy. Yeah.
As long as it's not powers out.
Nikos versus Club.
Nikos 200%.
Yes?
Yes. It is authentic Greek, like, people that run that, and they're very friendly. The food's great.
Well, I had it last time, but then I'm just going down the list.
I mean, if you want to experience...
No, I want a good pizza.
Oh, Nikos is the way to go, man. Good. Definitely.
I'm no DJ for nobody.
I hear you. Yeah, man, it's great pizza.
Hey, the Rocket League that was on the server.
Yeah.
Is that their full copy?
That is like a restore for Steam. So if you pull that down and then in Steam go to like backup and restore and point at that folder, it'll restore it. It'll install the game and you won't be able to launch it unless you purchase it.
I was just wondering, because I know some games give you some really weird stuff for LAN parties and some just don't.
Yeah, no, I wish, but that's not one of them, unfortunately.
That's cool.
Yeah. So Steam has been having issues, by the way. One of the reasons why we're doing CSGO now, I don't know if you've caught the schedule before, this block was actually supposed to be Rocket League. It was switched with CSGO because we can host local servers for CSGO. And because Steam and Rocket League were having issues with their servers, we tried to delay it so that hopefully that was resolved. So I'm guessing that's probably why Squiddy is showing offline right now. I'm not entirely sure. He might just be, you know, relaxing until their game, too. Who knows?
Is this live?
No. It's 1-on-4.
It's 1-on-4, is that what you said?
4-on-4.
Oh, 4-on-4.
Might as well be 4-on-4. Pinhead got all 4 kills.
Pinhead Larry, man. He pulls in the numbers. Yeah, we get really good luck when we host these events. You know, if it's League of Legends, they're getting DDoSed. These Steam games, Steam's having issues. We work through them, though. We've got a good shot.
Really hot.
Yeah.
Online connection, the entire table's internet goes out.
You know, standard LAN stuff.
What does that say, Debo?
Auto kick.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
I can be lazy and not have to get out of my chair.
All right. No more jumping jacks for Devo. That's good. He's looking pretty rough over here. So.
Aaron, can you please come up to Devo's table, please?
Devo's table. Who cares? Since you're not very talkative over here.
The game is not live yet.
I don't care.
Okay. Well,
basically, Pepper just talks some shit and doesn't know what he's talking about now.
No, I know what I'm talking about.
I think he's getting a lot of hate mail right now. He was on his phone.
Yeah, you know. My stream was wondering.
Oh, God.
Now, when you say your stream, do you mean you and your bot?
Yes.
So this isn't, okay. This is the warm-up. Okay.
Yeah. Which is why I'm not putting much effort into it.
I assume that everyone on the stream can hear the announcements. They're trying to get people into the servers.
It's almost like they don't want to win these beautiful cloud.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I guess we can kind of sell out and mention the prize. It's actually really nice.
I mean, they took their time.
No, I'm not saying, you know.
What brand is it?
HyperX. By Kingston.
That's good. At least it's not some SteelSeries.
Good. Okay. I'm going to leave now.
No, I'm kidding.
I feel bad. I don't like to spam a whole bunch of, like, you know.
Hashtag follow the stream.
Adverts or anything, but.
Yeah, no adverts or anything.
You don't have a camera. What are you pointing at? Anyway, Kingston is the sponsor of this tournament for us.
Or
the winning team will get a set of Cloud 2 headsets. I'm not just saying this because they're the sponsor. If people ask me what kind of headset they should buy, this is the one that I recommend. It's affordable, it's comfortable, it's a really good headset.
Halt, can you please get into server 2?
Do you know who he is? Halt?
He's a shadow.
I'd say just go up to him personally and be like, hey, listen, hey, Halt.
Did you just make a pun?
What?
What?
Did you just make a bad pun?
No.
I thought it was a Halt joke.
Oh, no.
There we go. Halt's in the server.
Halt's in the
server.
We're
ready to go live.
We've got Halt now.
Restart and go live. We ready to go.
Yeah, the Cloud 2 headset from Kingston.
Warm up is not running still.
Counter-terrorists win.
I'm just trying to help the admins out. I can do work from over here too.
How are you doing, Adam?
I'm good.
You doing good?
I'm good, yeah.
Pepper's gone quiet.
Did the round start?
No, but we do have 5v5 now, I think. I don't think it's live. Is it live?
They're going to reset, yeah.
Okay. Alrighty. Yeah, it is a really nice headset. And it's kind of surprising from them, too. You know, Kingston, it's basically one of their first gets into the peripheral market from memory, and they really nailed it. So it's really good to see.
It's actually their second dip into the market because, well...
Mousepads? What was their... Okay, well, I mean the original headset. Shut up.
Also, the reason we're not in Witty's game is because, other team is given a 10-minute break. They need 10 minutes to prepare for Witty. Or just smoke.
Or eat dinner. You know.
I'm waiting. I've been waiting on Clinton, Elliot to get back for an hour.
Oh, where'd they go?
They went to the hotel to swim and then go get Little Caesars. Yeah, swim. I'm gonna go back to the room and see how moving and sweaty men. It's gonna be disgusting.
I'm not even going to respond to that.
Well,
I'm gonna sleep in the shower. So the weather today.
Okay.
Sweaty so, with a chance to move.
Please God, no. I'm telling you, that's when he's going to come back from getting water, and he's going to hear that phrase.
And we are live.
We are live now.
Live now. Live now.
Live. Is this live?
Yeah, this is live.
This is live.
The typical strat for CTs is one outside, one heaven, two ramps.
I see one outside. Two coming out the big door.
What the hell just happened?
I guess it's not a big door on this map, is it?
That is Mini.
Yeah.
He's going to CT red. Bomb is down to Mini.
Man, what a terrible time to run out of six bullets.
Yeah.
Two Daves in a bad spot. Bombs up on A. He might progress through hell. Or...
Bomb is outside and looks like it's actually going to circle right down into Two Dave's face. Boomerkin's got
I'm confused.
A.
No, Bomb's still down, yeah?
Yep, Bomb's down.
Yeah, Bomb's not on the move.
It's an interesting strat, saving round one. Probably gonna go heaven. One heaven.
Two Daves having a problem with the ladder.
11 damage falling off the ladder.
Would you say that's a bold move?
And right as he pops his head out, pop goes the weasel.
It is actually very hard to get up heaven when you have someone watching like that, because as soon as you pop up off the ladder, you expose yourself.
And CT went round one.
kits. Usually second round, if you win the first, is armor, submachine gun, or armor shotgun.
Boomerkin says, armor P90, go suck it. And he gets two heads.
There's another one pushing.
Three.
Can he get five this round?
We're counting.
Do they mindlessly push?
I don't think they look like they've given up on that.
Wait, did he just see someone?
That was a teammate.
Okay.
Two Daves is...
Well, you know, shooting teammates hasn't stopped anyone else in this tournament, so...
I mean, that's
hanging
why Two Daves was
lobby.
Playing on Rolf's account, wasn't
yeah.
it?
Hanging out in my lobby waiting for the CTs to rotate. CT's still sitting back, playing their positions, which is good. Going squeaky.
Chaos calling against the other two.
That's too bad.
This guy's pretty good.
Not a fan of Nuke.
Nuke is very... It's actually been taken off the professional rotation because of how CT-sided this map is. So
oh, really?
I wouldn't be surprised to see Terra's win no rounds.
Mirage is in the rotation, by the way.
Mirage?
Let you know that.
Mirage.
I specifically requested Mirage go into the rotation because no one wants it.
It's well balanced. I like it. They play it very often. Halt with the scout. Yeah. Another shot.
Little peek.
Zane scouts and knives. You got limited ammo.
He
hits another head.
Outside.
Oh,
and
pinhead.
Pinhead
will
clear it up.
Picks up two.
Sig sour.
Pinhead is
Boomerkin's
on fire.
Getting greedy, pushing.
Well, you're up 2-0.
I'm pretty sure Pinhead has killed all of the CT at this point.
That's what I heard. I'm gonna go eat.
Pinhead has
okay.
five of these six
pretty
kills.
Pretty good, man. How about you?
Glad I could finally make it.
Yeah, me too.
You guys having fun?
We are, yeah, we're casting live, man.
Nice.
So,
we have no idea what we're talking about.
Cool. That's awesome.
Yeah, we're trying to sound like we know what we're talking about, but.
I'm just going to go ahead and admit it.
Wait, is this an actual tournament game, or?
Yeah, this is the CSGO tournament live.
Nice.
I don't know if we're in second round or if this is still first round. Second round. Debo knows. I don't.
We're on Nuke.
Cool.
We're on Nuke. I actually think this is third round.
Yeah.
Is it third round? Okay.
It's third round. Yeah, we're waiting on the team to get them third round.
Which means next round is Witty.
Is it Witty?
Okay. Good job. Is Mirage.
Just mastered Rocket League in about 20 minutes.
Oh, really?
Kind of a boss, yeah.
You've been playing it for a lot longer than 20 minutes.
20 minutes?
No, a lot of time has passed since you started playing Rocket League. It might only feel like 20 minutes.
I mean, it might have only been 20 minutes because of the lag.
That's true. Lag and power.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Debo. You can send all hate mail to debo@lanoc.org. I don't think you have an email account, actually.
I do.
Do you? Is it Debo?
No, I never say, yeah, it's actually my name. @lanoc.org. Thanks.
You're welcome. You deserve every
spam
little
on my
bit
now.
Of spam you get.
I was being nice and wearing a SteelSeries hat for you.
No one can see it. We don't have a camera. I mean, we do have a camera. We just don't have the source. About to set. Thank you.
Giving out my staff email on the internet.
Yeah, no one gives out email on the internet. I don't know what I was thinking.
Evildoer, you upset me. You did not win with a P90.
Two Daves looking for a kill here.
He just wanted to break things.
That sounds like Two Daves. Got Boomerkins, the lone survivor on CT.
With a dirty, dirty auto sniper. Bombs planted. Does he try to defuse?
And
he's got a kit, so I mean, he's going to try.
Terrorist going to pull out a win here?
Yeah,
all right, then.
Boomerkin saves a really expensive gun.
That's good.
Yeah.
It's economical.
Not quite an op, but it fires more bullets in a row than an op.
Is Boomer our op? I don't think he was our op. I thought that was Red Riser.
Yeah. Boomer is the auto sniper. He's a dirty, dirty man.
I think he can hear you. He's going to come over here.
He's like right there. Thanks to NVIDIA, by the
way. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We have free soda at Lan OC. Thank you for that segue. I'm going to go get myself a Red Bull. You need anything?
Dr. Pepper.
Diet or regular?
Regular.
Good. All right. You did all those jumping jacks, though. You're gonna throw those away?
Yeah, because I'm allowed to be idle.
All right.
Boomerkin just blowing holes in doors. Bomb is planted. Is it gonna go economic again?
Okay.
Oh.
Now
that halt.
Because you haven't ate.
I haven't had dinner yet. No.
Yeah. Halt without a kit is gonna get bad.
Thought you were gonna go with some sort of poem there.
I'm a regular Walt.
Did you just... Are we muted?
I made you look like a dick in order to open pop.
Oh.
And then I muted myself.
Are we muted right now?
No, we're not muted at all.
We're not muted.
Any insults you make to me are now available to the internet.
That's how I prefer it. Sent Devo hate mail on the forum. Good call.
This man made an account. Just send me hate mail. I feel
there is
loved.
No better reason to make an account than send Devo hate mail.
I feel more loved by the guy who created an account, send me hate mail, than I do by my fellow staff members who have me sitting over here in a corner.
I'm over here.
And I'm visiting.
That's only 15% of the land, but I'm over here. Yeah, I'm gonna get a pizza at some point. You can't have that much left, can you? You don't mind?
Yeah.
Alright.
I think I need it.
Be right back, I'm gonna go microwave this.
Blow another power circuit.
Pop a breaker.
No. No breakers, I don't need servers dead. I don't need matches to restart anymore.
No, we'll just take Gus offline for like the 8th time today. Come here as a sponsor. Tries to enjoy a lovely land with his daughters. We blow his power 5 times.
Bomb has been defused.
You're
and
jerk.
TT wins. Terrorists win. By the way, there is a CSGO tournament going on.
No.
Really?
My bad.
So where's the Lan OC podcast?
You know, I think we were kind of gauging the stream for interest. And I was hoping to be able to convince Wes that we need to do one.
Seems like we're having fun with our four friends right here.
You guys would listen to a podcast, right?
Like they're going to talk to you?
They are. You'll see.
Hank sitting in the fog and all he can see are bullet ricochets off the metal and he's just like, I'm not moving.
I'm not dead yet.
Boomer begins with another takedown, pinhead Larry through the door. And action, Hank. Last man left. He is the bomb. He is getting circled in the
entire.
No dice.
We do have individual streams.
We do indeed.
Debo's probably more than mine, because he actually puts effort into it.
Play Final Fantasy. I don't play very popular games, though, so I tend to struggle.
Every game that anyone's talked about at this LAN, you know about. Don't tell me you don't play popular games.
I know about everything because I have no life.
Sounds like a pretty good life.
I've been going to LAN parties for about 20 years.
That sounds like an awesome life.
I'm 38. I've been playing for a very long time. Probably since the exact amount of time it started.
Terrorists win. It started in 98.
And that is a team switch. It's 7-1 going into halftime. Not looking good for the Larry team. Looks like Tude is going to make a quick exit. Is the other match underway?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yep.
These guys are good, but we need to go see Witty.
I believe we did promise to stream some Witty.
He's promised to stream some Witty. Server's not responding.
Which server are you seeing?
Oh.
Should be server 2.
Oh,
should I have server 1 and server 2? And it should
be the Inferno.
Server 2?
The
what were you
team,
into?
The one with the 10-minute break?
Oh.
I was in the newer.
Oh, so you're still... Okay, are you going back to Team 1?
Yeah, I'm going back to Team 1.
Yeah, so that'll be Inferno. Sorry.
For Mr. Witty.
I was trying to figure out which one you were.
Witty!
There he
wow,
is.
His team is stacked. He has Mad Dog.
Mm.
Yeah, they haven't played. This is actually their first...
Ty Lord versus Witty.
And they're already taking out a few kills there.
Okay, we're just going to stay on Witty. This is a Witty
stream. Oh, we do have Ty Lord versus Witty, though. Ty Lord was a... crowd
so,
favorite.
Yeah.
From the previous
but
round.
But Witty's already got 10 kills. It's 3-2. Witty's got 10 kills.
Well, he's not against Pepper yet.
4-2,
so.
Yeah, so. I mean.
Some nice knife skills there.
He's just switching the knife.
Don't listen, man.
Like, that's not him actually doing it. You know that, right? This is a video game. That's just an animation.
Wait a minute. You're telling me.
Yeah, I don't
know. Damn.
We have considered it. Usually about every Sunday at 5 o'clock.
We were just told we need to just quit the LAN.
I can go flip the breakers until everyone go home. Going off. Oh my god, Witty.
It's the best thing to
we'll
do.
Be there for the next one.
Yeah, you
know. I'd like to come to a Fort LAN, to be honest, but it's already 100 miles to here.
Where are you?
I'm in Huber Heights. Dayton.
Dude, I'll come get you.
Yeah. That's a long ride. I barely go to the one that's 20 minutes away. Do this twice a year and you run out of steam.
No, see, I do this twice a year and then I go to all the other lands to have my fun.
You know me, right? I don't have fun.
No, you're too serious.
Fun is not how I operate.
Yeah, you go Witty
is going on.
You go to lands and play Final Fantasy.
Hell yeah. I gotta play Final Fantasy for the stream later. 14.
Did they lose somebody? No.
I used to play 11.
Are we live or is
yeah,
this
we've live? Been live. We're like Witty. We're just shooting the shit, watching Witty kill everyone.
Well, you know, he's doing the Witty thing.
He's hosting us, so we're giving him screen time.
Yeah, that's true. And we were just talking about being sellouts.
I mean, he's not dying, so...
Okay.
Oh, he's got a nip gun?
Well, they're on a break until we get through this and the next round.
Cyrex. No stickers on the Cyrex, though. Gonna have to call him on that one.
I think he had a CSGO logo on it.
Team 6 did win in that match, in the match we just stopped watching.
Hashtag the Witty thing, yep. No.
We'll see how it goes.
Lan OC version 17 brought to you by Witty.
Just remember... You saw him here first. competitively. Maybe. I don't know.
No, no, they're actually watching that. They're not streaming the picture. Huh? They're not. You're not streaming the web game, right?
No. Oh
my God. You really have the ultimate person.
I promise I would have told you.
He would have. Waiting with a headshot on Red Riser. That's
right
telling.
Now it's just an overlay with this.
Team Switch, halftime, 6-2. Looks like Witty's got a showdown with
bombs.
Pepper if he keeps going this way.
It's actually his computer. This is like Debo's setup.
Lots of Debo's pizza I'm eating. Conveniently.
I'm just going to say this.
Garrison! Witty's going off, man. Yeah?
He's 13-3. 8 rounds in.
What team's he on? Team
one. Team one.
Team one
is Team Witty.
We don't need to play them next, right?
Okay, your team is
five.
Yep.
That's who we're playing next if they win.
Yep.
Oh, we got another person about to get Witty over here. Oh, we're on D-Bro. I'm sorry. Witty died.
Harrison's already promised us to kill a round on Witty, so you don't need to worry.
Oh, we switched to D.
You'll
Mirage?
Be on
Mirage?
Nuke?
Oh, you're on Nuke.
Okay. Yeah, they'll be on Nuke.
Mirage is
what
line
are we starting?
We started Terrace last time.
Sounds like Garrison's getting nervous.
No, I'm not getting nervous.
If it's Nuke.
Hey, if I had my way, we'd have CT, hostage rescue maps on this.
No, terrible.
We'd have some Italian office
get
and militia rolling around here. But you know, it's not up to me because they keep telling me I take up too much time with my tournament ideas. You're not allowed to have group stages.
Are you in charge of the tournament still?
Nope.
Aww. Who does the tournament organization?
Those two.
That's the brain trust right there.
I do a little bit of the old school.
It must be so hard.
No network ports on the GameCube. Don't have to worry about that.
What do you do, though?
I click pictures.
Make pictures. Where'd Witty go? I can't watch a game with Witty dead.
You hang posters?
Blocky is all that is left, and he's got a bomb down in B, right on the fountain.
I think Big Spence actually did
taking
a lot of
out, fast or not. No kits. Tick tock, tick tock.
Bomb has been defused.
Counter terrorists win.
He's right over there.
No, I don't want to.
You want me to introduce you?
No, I
don't need to be introduced to Ed. Ed is a great guy.
I don't
want to say anything. Just say hi, Ed. And you're Ed's friend. So, Witty died and they lost the round. That's pretty much the story. Witty dropping fast or not, and now he's got a shotgun. Round the corner, and that's the end of him. Bomb is in B, along with three escorts. Tyler down to Glocky. Red Riser takes out PB. If the bomb is down, Mad Dog Glocky. All defending against D-Bro. D-Bro down. Red Riser, you're the only hope. Logan Bro down. Mad Dog secures the victory. 7-3. Witty bringing up the back end of a rush up the alley. Into B. Haven't seen any action on A, really. Smoke out.
around the mountain into construction and land behind the coil. Witty, not even pointing at the chicken. Everyone, almost everyone has to point at the chicken and try to flash out. Frag out. Well, that was smoke.
We're not going to get
smoke
it.
Out. Full terrorist five-man defense against Red Riser, who has a deagle. Yep, Flocky takes him out. Another wipe. Match point for Terrorist and Team 1. Woody's got that M4 finger, huh? Not so much on the AK. Whoa, right around the corner. That's a P90 in Woody's face. Fastronaut heading to A, where the Terrorist will meet him. That was a very interesting Molotov.
Bomb has been planted.
That's his own teammate, but the bomb's down in A. The UMP. One down. Almost two. Oh, Red Riser takes out Fastronaut. Cleans it up. 10 seconds of the defuse. We just got more than enough time without the kit. And CT survives one more round. Still not down. About the next four rounds are going to be match point. Standard rush up the alley B. Whoa, a flash. And Red Riser, they Mexican standoff right here. Right around the corner. Smoke will go down. Frag will come out. This is why you buy Molotovs, kids. Perfect example of buying Molotovs. Meanwhile, D-Bro hanging out in A. Here comes the rotator rounds. CT's playing really strong defense. Knowing it's match point from here on out until the tie. Woody picks out Tylor. He's successfully rotated in through, but the bomb's up an apartment. Logan Bros taking out Fastronaut. Clone, or D-Bro taken out by Witty. And that leaves Red Riser and Clone to go to A. Clone just put way too much bullets into Red Riser. So Blocky puts him in the head. And now Red Riser down 10 HP from simply his teammate. Bomb down in A for Terrorist guarding it. There's an HE out. The flash himself. Taken down, map down, Witty moves on. Along with the rest of his.
Well, you tell them. I don't think I
unless they tied on nuke, we're done here.
Streaming this?
We're back live next round. We're in Nuke. Oh yeah, the Pepper Witty game. Pepper's already dead, so there goes that 10 kills. Oh, this is all warm up. Talking out my ass. Warm up. them, so we're going to take some advent shots. And this is just a reminder that the Rocket League tournament will be starting almost immediately after the end of this one. So we'll get to see some car soccer after we get to watch some people shoot each other in the face. And then that'll be it for the tournaments for the night, but we'll have a raffle around midnight. More prizes, more mayhem, less trying to be funny. Out here. I'm gonna have the mic muted real quick and I'm gonna yell out how many seconds are left. And we are live. Console getting happy. We are live. Now remember, Pepper said 10 kills.
Rotate.
He got two, and there's one on Witty. We're starting off just like he said he would. Looking for another kill on Gadoos. Halium returns. PBJ's down in B and all alone. It's one of the most exposed plant sites. And that's CT winning round one. Pistol round to CT. But it's nuke, so I mean that's to be expected. Rotating through a quick B rush. And oh, Pepper taking two kills. Witty takes out Caboose. He's got to get the bomb. Bomb is down. Red Dragon X taking out Witty. CT 2-0. Pepper, 4 kills. Remember he's over here, he said 4 kills, 10-0. Or 10 kills, 9-0 on the match. So... we shall see. Baron and HP, but bomb train goes to A today. And Logan Bro had a Molotov lined up, but Pepper up in heaven. Red Dragon going off. Pepper doing just as well. The fuse on the bomb, and we are at 3-0. Counter-terrorists win. Witty outside takes out Halium. Drew puts the bomb down. Witty taken out by Pepper. Well, normally when he talks a big game, he flubs it up, but Pepper is actually holding his own. PBJ is death bomb and is heading him down. Oh, they're both out. We go to pistols. Glocky Glocks. And that is the end of the round. Terrorists win their first round, 3-1. Kind of stuck. between A and the ramp to B. The boost down by PPJ, but Ender takes out Witty from behind. It's a P90 run. The bomb's on PBJ. Pepper takes him out. And it won't be 9-0, but Pepper does have 8 kills. Pepper doing a little team killing. He only managed to throw that AG down there when the team decided to go outside for a rush. Outside and around the mini, maybe? That will advertise your position. Sorry about that, guys. Just punch my mic. Gets the kill on Red Dragon. But it's Pepper takes out Witty. Takes out Ender. Halium takes out Door and takes out. And Logan Bros all that's left. He gets Caboose for a trade. 35 seconds left in the round. The bomb's out in mini. Problem with that weird unconventional placement. CT. And for the Pepper kill count, we are at 9-1. Hello, Winnie firing blind. Pepper takes him out. Are caught in the hallway. Gunfire coming in on him. Logan Bros, Prey and Prey get taken down by Ender. Pepper just stalking the bomb.
Counter-terrorists win.
Out Glocky. That's 10 kills. That's 12 kills. 6-1. My colleague appears to have left the building.
Yep, let's win it.
CT dominated map though, so this could easily go back the other way. Go the back way. Or TV go outside, CTs go in, leaving pretty much nobody outside, but they went outside and went under. So, kaboom. Down, terrorists win 9-1. Pepper got 16 kills instead of the 10 he said. Witty gets a case, but Witty is out of the tournament. I need to get Pepper over here for talking shit all last match about how he was going to kill Witty 10 times and win 9-0. And he almost got what he came for. He got 16 kills. 9-1. 9-1.
Thank you.
we will get in. We will be going to the finals of the CSGO tournament, and then the Rocket League tournament will directly follow right after that. Unfortunately for the fans of Team Witty, he was just eliminated by Pepper, actually backing up the crap that he was talking about on the stream earlier. So, it's a sad day. We are live and back. Get that music out of here so we can hear. For terror, Team 5 taking command here on the Mirage. Looks like the rush to A with no to CT defense. Blocked by smoke.
Bomb has been planted.
And two ops coming, or two scouts coming the other way. They're all alone. Bomb down in a three, circling around them. Where he is now, Boomerkin brings him down. Kit on the bomb. Defuse, defuse, defuse.
Dig Dug. And the keys start rotating instead. Looks like they're headed back to B. Bailed out, sucked a few in, sent the CTs to A, and then came right on back around.
Bomb has been planted.
Bomb down in B. These have realized this. Clay takes out Karazin, Zal takes out Ender, Red Dragon takes out both of them, and it's a Scar 20 versus a Smoke.
Terrorists win.
Red Dragon takes out the auto. Terrace up 4-1. Here's it on an economy run, whipping off. That's the kid real close. The bomb stuck in a hard place between two CTs. Flash up from Caboose. Takes out Holt. Right around the corner, he knows Clay is right there. Did you see the P90? Smoke down. Two CTs, he held them all. The bomb just turns and books it straight to A, right behind the nukes.
Bomb has been planted.
Now, here comes Clay, and boom. C-bomb, kit bomb, nod. Oh, down. With the kit, Clay claims victory.
Bomb has been defused. Counter-terrorists win.
Delay circle back around the mid thing they've been doing. Ender going underneath into that. Harrison sneaking has no idea how close he is right here. Dig Dug. Chaos Play takes out Harrison. Bomb is down. Bomb is back up. Takes out Death the Kid, Chaos Play takes out Ender, and the bomb is not down yet. The bomb transferred to Dread Dragon, who is heading to A, whose only guard is Clay. Boomerkin takes out Halion, the Red Dragon takes out Clay, and we have a one-on-one. The bomb will be planted down in A.
Bomb has been planted.
Boomerkin.
Terrorists win.
Out behind the box, Red Dragon wins. 5-2.
Good
Dragon both down.
Thank you very much.
Hulk takes out Karazin's, Red Dragon takes care of Hulk, and we got three T's in A. Looks like Boomer can...
Bomb has been planted.
Is the MP9 really worth saving? Just too much. End it with a P90, takes it down 62. And that's the end of the half. With Team 5 firmly in the lead. Harrison's not having the same kind of game he had last time. This time, Red Dragon picking up the slack for the 13 kills in the first half. Dig Dug at the end, almost got all five. Red Dragon cleans it up. And that's gonna help the score when you get four kills in one round. Pepper putting a little spice on it. And we are two rounds from 2-5 taking it. Killed his firstborn child. Gotta do all the play-by-play when you're sitting in this chair. Harrison's got a P90, a little bit better than the pistol he just won, basically won the last round with. We're on match point. Match point, tournament point. Winner gets a Cloud 2 headset. And it looks like the T's have taken a Rush A approach to this map. Ender is smoked with a P90, fires blindly into it, gets nothing. Death the kid. Red Dragon spraying a P90 over the top of the box, just doesn't get any love from the army. Hulk gets a kill on Helium. Garrison takes out Chaos Clay. Terrorists down to 2 on their tournament lives. Halt and Dig Dug. An MP7 and a P90. Bomb is down in the hall from T-Spawn.
Ender
takes out Dig Dug. Match over. Team 5 is your winner.
Good game, guys.
Thank you, everybody, and be sure to stick around a very short amount of time. We will be going into Rocket League.